Welcome to Intro to Office 2013 video project number 14. Hey, in this video, we got to talk about tabs. Now, I've already opened up a blank Word document and saved it with the name Fun with Tabs. If I hit F12, you can see the file path up here. It's the same file path we've been using all class for Word. I'm saving it to Word Class Notes. Escape there. Now, tab. What's a tab? Well, we've all seen the tab key. Tab. 0.5 is the default. Tab, tab. And watch this. When I hit Enter, tab. Oh, it looks like as I hit Enter, the tab always carries forward. It's always 0.5. Now, in a couple of videos ago, we did our research paper, and we learned that we don't have to do tab for a research paper because we can do what's called a first line indent. But for some things like for business letters, other documents, you have to set a tab at some other position besides 0.5. Our business letter in our next video, we'll set it to 3.5. So I'm going to hit Enter, and I want to show you how to set tabs. And then there's a bunch of different types of tabs. Now, tab is a paragraph level formatting. So if I go up to the paragraph group on the home ribbon and click our Dialog launcher, I see the tabs button, I click it, and there's tabs. Recently, someone at YouTube posted a keyboard for tab. I've been looking for this for years. It's Alt-O-T. Oh, that is amazing. Now, there's the default setting. There's left, center, right, decimal, and bar, and we'll look at each one of those. Let's set a tab stop, 3.5. I'm going to click Set, click OK, and now watch this, Tab. When I hit Tab, whoa, look what happens up there. There's a little left mark. That means the tab has been set at 3.5. Now watch this, paragraph level formatting. Why? Because when I hit Enter, Tab. So it carries forward. The reason it carries forward is usually, like in a letter, you'll have the date and then your signature and your name, all with the same tab stop. Now let's type. So the dog went out to lunch. That's from the left. So we set a 3.5 tab left. Now let's look at centered. Alt-O-T. I'm going to click Center. Set. We don't need to clear it. Now it'll replace it if I click boop. Click OK. Now when I hit tab, if I type, oh, it's centered right there. Enter. Alt-O-T. Let's do right. Set. OK. Tab. Now when I type, oh, from the right. Now what about decimal and bar? Enter. Alt-O-T. Decimal. Now decimal does something totally amazing. I'm going to click OK and watch. When I hit tab, 12.23, enter tab, something, and then a bunch of decimals. The decimals are lined perfectly, or lined up down the middle. Zoop. Now, let's see if I can scroll down here. Alt-O-T. Let's look at bar. And bar does something similarly surprising if you've never used it. Click OK. Oh, it puts a line there. Now, watch this. You have to set another tab. And I'm not going to set it in the box. I'm going to come up here and use my ruler. So I'm going to set it at 4. And that's a left. In fact, if we Alt-O-T, we can see that it has been added. There's that 4. Now watch this tab. Oh, it's like a bar down the middle. And so we start typing. And every time we hit Enter, the bar comes down, and if I hit tab, I go back to 4. Paragraph level formatting being carried forward. Control V. All right, I'm going to hit Enter, Alt-O-T, whoops, Alt-O-T, clear. Now, just for kicks, we looked at all of these. A leader, as you can imagine, if I select right and this, when I click OK, tab, and then I could type, do my typing. Enter. Oh, it's coming off the screen here. Tab. Enter. Let's look at one other thing. We can set, we saw how we set a tab up here. So down here, Alt-O-T, I'm going to clear it. So you can set your tab, and watch this. It'll give you a little pop-up. So that's left, then there's center, right, decimal, bar, and there's even, we remember from our research paper, that is a first line indent. That is a hanging indent, and then back to left. So if I wanted to come up here and set a first line indent, notice my cursor's right there. So when I set a first line indent at 1, now when I type, and hit enter, all of the paragraphs are set at first line indent 1 inch. So you can actually set whatever tab you select over here by using the ruler. All right, that was a lot about tabs. In our next video, we'll do a business letter, and we'll use a few tabs. All right, see you next video.